the musician. Rich stepped into the gazebo. "Hi, I'm Rich. I have a quality wood care service and I'd love to be of assistance." The musician laughed. "My, you're a young entrepreneur. Unfortunately, this gazebo isn't mine, but my flute could do with a polish." Rich sat down and looked out at the sea. He'd never noticed before how big it was. "Could I tell you my vision?" Rich began. And the musician let out a light whistle from her flute and then paused. "Draw it for me." And that's what he did for the next 20 minutes as she continued to play her flute. And you can see what Rich drew. It's illustration 13. So when Rich had finished drawing, the musician said, "So now tell me why you might fail." Rich thought about that. It wasn't because he would make mistakes, because he planned to fail. It wouldn't be because he would be wasting his time or his money, because he would be investing both. It wouldn't be because he would be moving too fast or too slow, because he would follow a rhythm. I don't know," he said. "How might I fail?" "Well, if you were to sow in the summer or reap in the spring, if you were to forget about," and she played her flute again, "harmony." And she looked over at Rich, and he noticed the most incredible sparkle in her eyes. "Tell me, Rich, what do you know about time?" "Well, I know that we wealthy people value it more than money. I know that we treat it very carefully because we see it as something precious. We hate to waste it." The musician nodded in agreement. "Time cannot be compared to money. With money, when you spend it, you can always get more. With time, once you spend it, it's gone. It never comes back. Time is your most precious asset, so invest in understanding it better." Rich added that to his list. It was point 20. Time is your most precious asset. So Rich asked, "So what can you teach me to help me understand time better?" The musician looked out at the sea. "Time has flavors," she said. "Learn how to taste it, and your wealth is assured." She paused. "I'll show you. Watch the waves." Rich looked out at the waves. They looked like every other wave he'd seen. The musician continued, "Breathe with the wave." Rich began to breathe in as the waterline receded and breathe out as each wave broke back up on the beach. The musician began to play her flute, playing notes up and down the scale, in time with the waves. Rich could hear the rower. Sustainable wealth follows a rhythm. He'd written that as point 19. But this was something else. A tingle went down Rich's spine with each new wave. A peculiar thing began to happen. He was no longer just Rich. He was something much bigger. As he breathed, he became the sea and the melody, and there became so much abundance. He suddenly saw how much he already had and how much more he had to give. He thought about his father. He thought about the mother that he'd lost. He had blamed her for dying, for leaving him and his father. He hadn't expected to meet her again, certainly not here and now. But his sense of oneness was overpowering. Instead of feeling overwhelmed, he felt an incredible calm. He felt a surging inner strength well up within. The strength surged through his body, up to his chest and up to his face and to his eyes. Rich felt an energy he could not describe. And as he looked out in harmony with some natural rhythm, he was struck by tremendous clarity. And then he saw it. With a twinkle in his eye, he whispered, "So that's what the world is supposed to look like." The musician stopped playing, but Rich could still hear the melody. "Can you taste it?" she asked. Rich nodded. The musician continued, "When you find true harmony, you find untold strength. Harmony is the foundation of wealth." And Rich quickly scribbled point 21. "Harmony is the foundation of wealth." And then the musician took Rich's pad and she drew a circle. You'll see it as illustration number 14. And then the musician continued, "In the sea there are ripples on waves, on currents, on tides. It's the same with time. There are seasons within seasons. There's a spring, summer, autumn, winter in each year and in each day. You have seasons in your life, in your relationships, in your investments and in your businesses. You have one in this journey you've taken today. You have seasons in your learning and in your actions. Right now you notice the seasons in your book. Your harmony gives you that knowledge." Richard thought about that. She was right. When you invest your time to sow, nurture, and reap your relationships and your investments, your learning and your passion, your vision and your focus, make sure you sow in the spring, nurture in the summer, and reap in the fall. It's not just what you do, it's when you do it. Richard wrote point 22, "Time has seasons." And then he followed up with point 23, "It's not just what you do, it's when you do it." The musician continued, "When you find your vision and clarity, you find your wealth. When you find your wealth, you can focus on how to invest your time. When you invest your time, you create value. And when you create value, your wealth begins to flow. And when your wealth flows with rhythm and harmony, it begins to resonate." "Do you know what it means to resonate, Rich?"
"Oh, I felt it, but I don't understand it."
"Well, when you resonate, you create a vibration like ripples in a pond. You create the most wonderful attraction. You attract the best people, the best opportunities, the best environment. And that's when you really begin to live life fully. When you resonate, you accumulate." Rich was reminded of the birds and the butterflies in the gardener's garden. He wrote point 24, "When you resonate, you accumulate." The sun was moving lower in the sky now, and the air was beginning to cool. Rich looked at the musician. He hadn't asked her how wealthy she was, but he realized he didn't need to. He could see the wealth in her entire body. He asked, Is that how you became so wealthy? You attracted everything to you?" The musician shook her head. "The attraction isn't the cause. It's the effect. When you begin to attract wonderful things, that's just the clue that you're on the right track. If you are not, that's a sign to recalibrate. The attraction is the reward you get for your efforts." "No, when I became a better musician," she said, "I developed clarity about when and where to create new investments, when to build them, when to sell them. I became a master of my time and my focus by just being in tune with the market and with my advisors. I came across the secret of all great wealth." "What's the secret?" Richard asked. "Well, that's for you to find out. Well, can you give me a clue?" The musician smiled and then began to play the same melody she'd been playing earlier. Rich looked back out at the sea. In mid-melody, the musician abruptly stopped. But the melody continued in Rich's mind. She turned to Rich. "I began to know which note came next." Rich looked at her quizzically, and another tune came into his head. "The world is waiting, anticipating." Rich saw his reflection in her smiling blue eyes. His reflection was twinkling. As he held her gaze, The musician winked.